Hello everyone, welcome to my channel which is Learning Institute, and today I am going to discuss about radioactive transformation series in detail. I have already discussed the radioactivity part, so let's start the video. So there are four main series of radioactivity element. First is uranium series, second actinium series, third thorium series, and the fourth one is Neptunium series. In the first three series, the parent radioactive element of large atomic weight and very long half period life give rise to a series of radioactive element. तो जो शुरुआती तीन series हैं उनके parent radioactive element का जो atomic weight है वो बहुत large है और बहुत long half life period है, जिसकी वजह से बहुत सारे रेडियोएक्टिव एलिमेंट मिलते हैं. सो गिव्स राइज टू अ सीरीज ऑफ रेडियोएक्टिव एलिमेंट. इन द फोर्थ सीरीज द पेरेंट एलिमेंट इज प्लूटोनियम विथ एटॉमिक नंबर 94 एंड द मास नंबर 241, बट द सीरीज इज नोन एज नेपच्यूनियन सीरीज बिकॉज नेपच्यूनियन हैज़ द लॉन्गेस्ट हाफ लाइफ पीरियड इक्वल टू 2.2 × 10^6 ईयर्स. So, when an alpha particle is emitted by the atom of a radioactive element, the new atom is remaining behind will have a mass of number A-4 and the atomic number of Z-2. तो जैसा कि हम जानते हैं कि जब अल्फा पार्टिकल इमिट होता है किसी एटम से, तो जो रेडियोएक्टिव एलिमेंट है वो उसके मास नंबर में 4 की कमी होती है और परमाणु क्रमांक में 2 की कमी होती है. तो उसका मास नंबर A-4 हो जाता है और एटॉमिक नंबर Z-2 हो जाता है. नाउ व्हेन अ बीटा पार्टिकल इज इमिटेड बाय एटम ऑफ ए रेडियोएक्टिव एलिमेंट, द न्यू एटम रिमेनिंग बिहाइंड विल हैव अ मास नंबर A एंड अ एटॉमिक नंबर Z+1. तो यहाँ हम देख रहे हैं मास नंबर में कोई चेंज नहीं होता और एटॉमिक नंबर एक इंक्रीज हो जाता है, एंड दिस रूल इज फॉलोड इन द रेडियोएक्टिव सीरीज. So the first is uranium series. In this case the parent element is uranium. जो प्रारंभिक element है जिसे parent element हम बोलते हैं वो uranium होता है, जिसका mass number with mass number A is 238 and Z is equal to 92. It is also known as uranium first or U first. Symbols हैं uranium first or U first. So uranium first emits alpha particles and the produced formed is uranium. Clear? So produced form is uranium X1 with Z equal 92 − 2 = 90 and A equal 238 − 4 = 234. So uranium X1 emits beta particles and the product formed is uranium X2 with mass number 234 and atomic number 90 + 1 = 91. Uranium X2 now emits beta particles and the product formed is uranium second with mass number 234 and Z equal 92. Uranium second is an isotope of uranium first, and the complete detail of the whole series are given in the following table. Which so this is the uranium series. So this series is very long due to long half-life period. So you can see here uranium first, symbol is U first, 92 to 238 emitted alpha particle, and the half-life is this. Similarly this series is very long, so you can write down or simply take a screenshot. So this is end with radium, end with radium G, symbol PB, lead 82 206, stable lead, mass number 206. So this is the uranium series. तो चाहे तो इसका स्क्रीनशॉट ले लें या फिर इसे लिख डालें. Now, actinium series, the parent element of this series is actinouranium with Z92 and mass number 235. The series ends with actinium D, that is stable, laid off atomic weight 207. This series is given below. So this is the sum part of actinium series. The parent element is actinouranium, AC actinouranium 92 and mass number 235, particle emitted alpha and half life is 7.13 × 10⁸ year. Then he emitted beta particle. The new isotope says UY, atomic number 90 and mass number 234 and 24.6 hours and so on. So also some part of actinium series is this. These are the actinium series ended with actinium D with atomic number 82 and mass number 207, stable, lead 207. Now the third is thorium series. The parent element of this series is thorium with Z equal 90 and A equal 232. The series end with thorium D, that is stable lead, of atomic weight 208. So this is the parent atom thorium with atomic number 90 and mass number 232, particle emitted alpha, and the half life period is 1.39 × 10⁻¹⁰ years. So these are the thorium series on successive emitted particles. And this series is end with thorium D with atomic number 82 and mass number 208. Stable, lead 208. Now the next one is neptunium series. The parent element in this series is plutonium with Z94 and mass number is 241. The series is known as neptunium series because the nuclide in it with the longest half-life period is neptunium with A equal to 37. So before the discovery of transuranic element neptunium, there was only three series as discussed already. The uranium series with uranium as parent element has a mass number equal to 4n+2. This is the general term where n is 58. So simply 4 × 58 + 2 is 4 × 8 = 32 and 234. So the actinium series is with parent element of actinouranium of mass number 235 becomes 4n+3 series. So uranium series is known as 4n+2 series. Actouranium or actinium series is known as 4n+3 series where n is 58. Similarly, thorium series with the parent element thorium of mass number 232 is known as 4n series where n equal to 52. It was considered that in this series 4n, 4n+2 and 4n+3, so there must be a fourth series, and this is the neptunium series. सबसे पहले जो तीन सीरीज डिस्कवर हुई वो 4n, 4n+2 and 4n+3, तो ये सोचा गया कि जरूर इनके बीच में कोई एक चौथी सीरीज होगी जो 4n+1 होगी, एंड दिस इज द नेपच्यूनियन सीरीज. एंड दिस सीरीज एंड विथ बिस्मथ A209 एंड दिस इज द नेपच्यूनियन सीरीज. Parent element is plutonium with atomic number 94 and mass number 241. Particle emitted is beta and the half life period is 14 year. And these are the long neptunium series. You can see here. And this is the last end with bismuth with atomic number Z and mass number 209. Stable, bismuth. So these are the radioactive series, and also this is important how how these series are classified in general terms. So these are the four general terms: 4n, 4n plus 1, 4n plus 2, and 4n plus 3. Clear? So 4n is thorium series, and 4n plus 2 is uranium series, 4n plus 3 is actinium series, and 4n plus 1 is neptunium series. So this is all about for today. I hope this video is clear to all of you. Thanks for watching video. Thank you.